Hello, today we will study electrical machine designing. First of all, before analyzing the rotor and generator circuit, we have to analyze the magnetic circuits and electric circuits. We all are familiar with electrical circuit. As you know, electrical circuit has a voltage source, resistance, inductor, capacitor, whatever, these all are impedance. If you apply KVL in this electrical circuit, then E will be, if this is E, then E will be RI. If I is the current circulating in this circuit, then E will be RI plus I time J L omega minus J time omega into C. Okay, now if you want to calculate the current in this circuit, then we can calculate I is equal to E divided by impedance Z, where Z is the R plus J omega L minus J upon omega C. Now these are basic concepts I have learned about it. But if you want to analyze the similar way magnetic circuit, then first of all we have to draw a magnetic circuit. Now consider this is a core and this is a supply which excites this core. If this is a EMF AC source and a flux circulate in this core. Now if you compare this magnetic circuit to this electric circuit, then we can see that here E equivalent, this E flux circulate in this circuit, here current circulate in this circuit, here resistance or impedance oppose the flow of current, here reluctance denoted by S opposes the flow of flux. It means flux is analogous to current, MMF is analogous to EMF, and S is analogous to impedance Z. Now if you want to calculate MMF, then MMF will be N into I, where N is the number of turns in this coil and I is the current circulating in this excitation circuit. Now this is air gap and this is core. If you consider the reluctance of this path is the summation of two reluctances. First is the reluctance of air gap and second is the reluctance of core. As you know, reluctance denoted by S is equal to L upon mu into A, where L is the length of that path where flux is circulating and mu is the permeability and A is the area in which flux is rotated. Okay, now as you know, mu, where is here permeability, it's depend on medium. For air medium it will be different and for core medium it will be different. So as you know, mu will be high for air media and mu will be minimum for core media. Now if you want to calculate MMF, then MMF will be total reluctance, which is the summation of reluctance of air gap and reluctance of core, multiply with flux phi. Similar as EMF is the multiplication of impedance and current. Here impedance is analogous to reluctance and phi is analogous to current. Now if you want to calculate reluctance of air gap, then here air gap length is LA, then Reluctance of air gap will be LA upon mu A into A, where LA is the length of air gap, mu A is the permeability of air gap, and A is the area. This area. Now, if one calculate reluctance of core, in similar way, reluctance of core will be L of CO. CO means length of core where flux is circulate. L of CO, mu of CO, and A is the area. Now, if you want calculate MMF, then MMF will be total reluctance multiply with phi. Here total reluctance is the SA and SO. We have added here and multiply with phi, where phi is the MMF upon S of total. S of total is this much. Now, we have discussed phi is the analogous to current, MMF is analogous to EMF, and S is the reluctance is the analogous to impedance. Now, this was the basic concept by using which we can calculate the rotor and stator EMF and reluctance, which is necessary for the analyzing of machine designing. Now, consider this is a machine. This inner part is rotor and outer part is stator, and in between rotor and stator is air gap, we all know. Now, here you considering the rotor. Rotor is a cylindrical area. I have shown this. This length is L. Then, if you want analyze the rotor behavior of magnetic flux and reluctance in rotor, then you have to select a small area of rotor and stator. I have selected this small area. And you want analyze this small area. You want calculate the all parameter of this small area. And after calculating it, we have generalized a concept. Now, come to point. This small area, whatever I have selected, drawn here. This is air gap. This length is air gap. This here is the stator and here is the rotor. Actually, rotor and stator is not shown here. This is three dimensional view. I'm trying to show it on paper. It is quite difficult, but I'm trying my best. Okay. If you consider here hidden part of stator and here hidden part of rotor. This is air gap. And here is hidden part of stator, here is the hidden part of rotor. I cannot show in three dimensional view on this paper, but I am trying. Then, this is air gap, as you know, I have analyzed this. And this is slots of rotor, This is tooth of rotor. Then, you want to calculate reluctance, then reluctance will be, if you assume flux is coming from starter side and cross the air gap and come to teeth. If you consider flux is coming from starter side, cross the air gap and come to rotor teeth. Then, for calculating the effective flux, we have to analyze the opposition in the path of flux, and that opposition will be S, reluctance. Then you have to calculate the reluctance. As you know, reluctance is the Sg is equal to Lg upon mu into A. Here A is the L into Ys. Ys is this length, and L is the core of length. Actually, inside the paper, L is hidden. I cannot show on this paper, so I have written here that Sg is the Lg upon mu into L into Is. It's quite difficult, but we have to analyze this three dimensional view on two dimensions. Now, come to point. Now, if you consider actual diagram of rotor and stator, then I have seen here this is air gap, and beyond air gap is a stator, and this side beyond air gap is the rotor, and this is slots and teeth, whatever is this. Okay, and the flux coming from stator side cross the air gap and come to teeth of rotor. Now this is the slots. I consider here slots have length ws, slots have length ws, and teeth have length wt, and this is flux which is coming from the stator side beyond the air gap. Here is a stator and here is the rotor. Now this length is ys. This diagram is called slotted armature with very small air gap. I have considered very small air gap, so this diagram is called slotted armature with very small air gap. Now if you want to calculate the reluctance in the path of flux, then you have to consider ys is length, known as slot pitch, ws is width of slots, and wt is width of teeth. Now if you want to calculate reluctance of air gap in this situation, denoted by here, I am denoting here as suffix g dash, then it can be written lg is equal to mu upon lg upon mu l into ys dash. Ys dash, what is ys dash? Actually this whole area from here to here, length is ys, but as you know, flux H current follows low resistance path. Similarly, flux follows low reluctance path, and here the flux offers very low reluctance. But here, where the air gap large, here flux follows very large reluctance. So flux cannot go here. He follow for shortest path, and that will be path of core. So I am sure that path will be less than. That path will be less than ys, and that length is denoted by y dash s. So I have written here that actual length that will not be ys, that will be y dash s. I have written here lg upon mu into l into ys. Now if you want to calculate y dash s, then y dash s will be, actually this length will be y dash, this length will be y dash s. And if we separate this half time ws and the half time ws here, then it will be ys minus ws, that will be y dash s. Then y dash will be ys minus ws. Then the reluctance can be written as lg upon mu into l into ys minus ws. Now actually, as I have explained before that flux follows low reluctance path. Here flux goes from stator side to rotor side only by air core path, but it's ideal situation. Practically it's not possible. Practically some little amount of flux passes through air like this. This is core. Flux actually passes here, but little amount of flux passes through here in this path. This behavior known as flux fringing. Now if you consider flux fringing in the same situation, I have considered here flux fringing in the same situation, then what will be change will be y dash s will be changed, and that change will be wt plus w time delta time ws. What is delta time ws? Delta is this small length. I have denoted delta s. And what is delta s ws? This is ws, this is wt. I have explained before. Then y dash s will be wt plus delta time ws. Here I have calculated wt is ws. I have add and subtract ws, and delta ws is here. Thus the phenomena will be, this whole expression will be ws dash s is equal to ws 1 minus delta time ws, and this 1 minus delta is denoted by kcs, called as quarters gap coefficient. It's a very important parameter of designing of electrical machine, and normally asked in semester exam, known as quarters gap coefficient. If in exam you are asking that, if examiner is asking you explain the quarters gap coefficient, then you have to explain all from here to here. Okay, now if you consider, now if you want to calculate reluctance of this flux fringing, reluctance of this path with flux fringing, then you can write it Sg is equal to Lg upon mu L and Ws minus Kcs into Ws. This expression y dash s I have written here, y dash s, and this expression will be, this is important expression for the exam point of view. Now I have calculated here three type of reluctances in three case. First I have calculated the in simple case, second I have calculated the slotted armature, and third I have calculated the flux fringing with slotted armature. Then if you divided S1G divided by SWG, then expression will be this, and if you have divided SG1 divided by SG, then expression will be this, and this expression will be called gap contraction factor. This expression also is a important parameter for the electrical machine designing, and normally it's asked in semester exam, so you have to prepare a data point of view that you have considered this important parameter for your semester examination. Thank you, that's all for today. I will explain.